Hello and welcome to a tutorial to make three-dimensional hyperbolic paraboloids. Paraboloids are a special kind of quadric surfaces and can be elliptical and hyperbolic. Hyperbolic paraboloid is also called saddle and is widely used in architecture as a tensile structure to make light, strong and nice roofs. I wanted to make this video about hyperbolic paraboloids for a while, but I just realized that I have been doing it the wrong way for so long. I had this divine revelation that they are ruled surfaces. Together with hyperboloids and another surfaces, ruled surfaces are the ones that, despite of being curved, they are made out of lines. Hyperboloids and elliptical paraboloids hide no mystery in their three-dimensional construction because they are surfaces of revolution. So it's very easy to draw them in a SketchUp using the Follow Me tool. Here you can watch my tutorial about bodies of revolution. Okay, let's make the hyperbolic paraboloid. Let's start with the most general case, which is the one where the four initial points 1, 2, 3 and 4 have different heights, and planes A, B, C and D are not parallel to each other. So there's no symmetry anywhere and we have to make the entire surface. As I said, this is a ruled surface. So what we are gonna do to build it is draw straight lines from line A to line C and from line B to line D. It doesn't matter that line A is longer than line C. What matters is that if we divide one in a number n of equidistant segments, we have to divide the other one in the same number n of equidistant segments. SketchUp shows you the midpoint of a line, so we use that to draw the first line that divides lines A and C in two equal segments. We do it again and now we have lines A and C divided in four equal segments, and then 8, and then 16, etc. I'm stopping in 8 to not make the video too long, but you get the idea. Now we do the same with the couple of straight lines B and D. Obviously, the more divisions we do, the smoother and more detailed the final result will be. When we are finished, magically, all the lines are divided in equidistant segments and there are intersection points everywhere. To create the surface, we just have to triangulate the mesh we just made, drawing the diagonals of each cell. We orient the faces that are not white, smooth edges, and it's done. To summarize the steps, I'll repeat it doing the easiest case, where the height of the four initial points are equal 2x2, and plane A is parallel to plane C, and B is to D. Being everything so nice and symmetrical, we only have to do a quarter of the surface. So the steps are: 1. Drawing lines from A to C. In this particular case, being symmetrical, we only have to do one half. 2. Draw lines from B to D. Same here, being this a special case, we don't have to get to the end. 3. Triangulate with diagonals. 4. Orient faces if needed, and smooth edges. This particular case, being symmetrical, we only have to copy this quarter of the surface, rotate it, and put it in the opposite corner. Copy everything, rotate it, and invert it by the blue axis. Well, I hope it was helpful. You can leave comments below to make questions or requests. Subscribe to the channel and watch the other tutorials that I made. Thanks for watching and see you!